Hello everybody and welcome to another watercolor tutorial. We're going to be painting this really neat Happy Father's Day card. I'm going to quickly show you how to draw this. So if this is your watercolor piece of paper in portrait position, you're going to first draw your hanger. So you can think of it as like a rounded triangle where at the top point you just add a little hook and that's your hanger. It's that simple. And then you can add three ties. So we're going to start with the one in the center and you just draw like a trapezoid shape, an elongated trapezoid shape. And then the two ties on the side are going to have the back part of the tie coming out. So another elongated trapezoid. But this time the little part at the back is going to stick out. And then same for this one, just like that. So it's that simple. Then you can just write whatever greeting you want here at the bottom, or you can write it at the top. So I've already sketched mine out how I'd like it. And the thing that you may want to do is just slightly erase your lines of your ties mainly. Not so much the hook, because we're going to be going over that with a darker color. But we don't want the pencil marks to show through our ties. So just erase them super lightly so that it's just visible enough for you to see. So we are going to start with our ties. And you can make them whatever colors that you desire. I am going to start with the one on the left here, and I'm going to paint it an orange color with yellow lines kind of going through it. So it's much easier, honestly, if you just paint them a solid color, because then you don't have to worry about these little details. But I wanted mine to be unique and not just a solid color. And here I'm just going to switch to a smaller brush because there are a lot of little details that, and I want to make sure that I'm not, you know, putting watercolor where I don't want it. And as always, I've included all of the brushes and supplies that I use in the description of this video, should you wish to add the items to your collection. Here I'm using a Winsor & Newton 00. I love this brush. It's very effective and it won't break the bank like some of those brushes. Mind you, I always started with kind of the worst of the worst when it comes to supplies. So I might not be the best person to advise what is good and what is bad, because like when I started using the Winsor & Newton brushes, because prior to that I used just really cheap dollar store ones, and wow, was it a difference. Like, I was like, how did I go using these poor quality paint brushes for so long when I could have been using these guys? But I've been using the Winsor & Newton for many years now and I'm very happy with them. The other thing I forgot to mention, it's not really important, I myself just added it kind of last minute, but I added these little clothespins to the tops of my ties, and this just adds a different element. Okay. And I also kind of like the, it looks like it was hand-painted, and I really like that look. Because if you're giving this to your dad, then I'm sure that he would appreciate, you know, a homemade card more than a store-bought card. So all those little imperfections just add to the painting. So, actually, I'm gonna, should I wait? I'm always so impatient. Let's see. Yeah. Okay, so now you just want to add the little yellow stripes in between each orange set of blocks. Just make sure that it's mostly dry before you add it, because you don't want that yellow to blend with the orange. I very often just, I don't wait long enough. And then it doesn't look great. So I'm gonna move on to my middle one here. And this one is going to be green. So yeah, the first thing you want to do is just outline your polka dots. And then you can go ahead with your paintbrush and just fill in all of the rest of the tie. The other thing you can do is simply paint the entire tie with a lighter color of green and then just go over it later with darker polka dots. That's definitely an option as well. If you did include a clothespin, just make sure you kind of paint around the clothespin. My last tie is going to be striped again, and it'll have blue stripes. But this time I'm going to have them going the other way. So don't forget to add all of the little details. So for my blue scarf, I'm just adding a thin black line in between each white space. I'm also filling in the little dots for my second tie. So the next thing I'm doing is taking a nude color, and I'm just filling in my clothespins, and I might go over them with some black watercolor once they dry, or even a black fine tip marker. We'll see how I feel. So now I'm just taking a fine tip black marker, and I'm gonna go over my hanger here. Clothes hanger. So if you don't have a fine tip marker, a pen works as well. You can even use black watercolor if you have a very steady hand. And you can also go over whatever greeting, I was gonna say holiday greeting, but you can write World's Best Dad, Happy Father's Day, whatever you would like. I've just chosen to go with the classic Happy Father's Day. And I always write out my greeting with pencil first before going over it with a marker, just because I am not always happy with my placement of my letters, or sometimes just the calligraphy or penmanship is not ideal. So if you go over it with pencil first, then you know you'll be happy with it. And that is basically it. Don't forget to erase any pencil lines once everything is completely dry, and you have your Father's Day card. I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. If you did, don't forget to subscribe to my channel, like this video, and I'll see you in the next one.